Hello everyone, thanks for clicking on a driving tour video in our driving tour playlist. Before you watch each of these videos, be sure to click on the little gear icon here for settings on YouTube, go to the quality for the playback, and play this in 4K if at all possible. The idea is that you just want to make sure you're watching this in the highest resolution that your internet bandwidth will support so the picture isn't all pixelated. Thanks.
All right, folks, welcome to the expansion pack. We're going to go see a few neighborhoods that are just a bit on the outskirts of the main part of Corvallis, so that you can get a feel for what it's like to live a little bit outside of town and maybe get some more space around you. This is a follow-up video to the long narrated tour of Corvallis neighborhoods. So if you haven't yet seen that video, check it out. We'll link it in the description below and in the cards on the screen. So thank you for tuning in. I'm Michael Krasilovsky of Team K Realty at RE/MAX in Corvallis. We're gonna start this off by going west onto Oak Creek Road. We're just north of the fairgrounds. You might remember this from the main video that we did. And we're just gonna go into what I'm gonna call the West Hills and take a quick jaunt on Grandview. As we take this stroll, it is a gorgeous fall day. It's early November, and it's been a little bit foggy today, but it's still just beautiful and the sun is shining. So we are now going west from Southwest 53rd Street on Oak Creek Road. And so the fairgrounds are to our left, Bald Hill is to our left. In a moment, we'll pass by one of the parking lots for Bald Hill. And as we finish Grandview, which is just a loop or a circle, we'll come back right up ahead where you see that road coming down off the hillside. So this is a great spot where if you want to still be pretty close to town, but in a very quiet feeling area, and maybe get like an acre or two or more of space around you, you can do that in these neighborhoods in the West Hills. Brown signs are for parks, so Bald Hill, Park, and Trail. Busy day there, a lot of people out hiking, biking, walking. And this is where we'll come right back out of on Grandview Drive. If we keep going straight, eventually this road dead ends at a trailhead, and you can go all the way over that trailhead into Philomath, actually, near Cardwell Hill Cellars, near the vineyards. But we are going up Grandview and just checking out one of these more rural Corvallis loops. That house on the left is owned by the folks that own Abundant Solar. They've always got some trucks parked there and obviously have a lot of solar set up, as do their neighbors, good neighbors, keeping their friends in business. Solar is becoming very viable as time goes by, even in the Mid-Valley in Oregon. So you can see you've got, you know, a few different home types here. You've got some pretty upscale modern architecture. You've got some, you know, older existing homes from the 70s and 80s, and you've got on occasion new builds as well. just for fun, we are about to pass by one of the four geodesic domes that I'm familiar with in Corvallis. So those are geodomes, as in Buckminster Fuller, the famous inventor and architect. And one of those four geodomes is up here on the right. And it looks like they're having a party. As we crest Grandview, you can see that, of course, it is named because of the grand views that you can get from some of these build lots. So we've got outstanding valley views, hills in the distance, coast range all over the place. I'm going to pay attention to driving, but one of those is probably Mary's Peak from this vantage point. And after this neighborhood, what we'll do on this expansion pack is we will go up into the Northwest Hills, into the Lewisburg or Vineyard Mountain area. And I think you're going to feel similarly. If you like this sort of neighborhood, you've got hillside with trees, you know, Vineyard Mountain, Lewisburg area is going to feel pretty similar. Haven't decided exactly which street we'll go on there, but it's kind of analogous to the West Hills. Here we are approaching the bottom of this particular example neighborhood and getting right back to Oak Creek Road. Alright, so folks, that's just a quick example of the West Hills. There's a bunch more neighborhoods that feel like that. And now we're going to go into an area just north of town.
Alright, so we are zipping in fast motion, and we are heading east on Oak Creek Drive, right back towards the intersection with Southwest 53rd Street, just north of the fairgrounds.
Here we are right back to 53rd Street, and if we kept going straight, we end up on Harrison Boulevard, and Harrison would take us right back in towards the College Hill neighborhoods, and then Central Corvallis right near the university, and ultimately towards downtown. Harrison, on the other side of Corvallis, is the two-lane bridge coming into downtown from the I-5 direction. Let's go up 53rd, take this over to Walnut, and then go north on Highland. We'll probably speed this footage up, but if you'd like to see a full normal video drive of the Corvallis Loop, we will link that in the description below and put it on the cards on the screen right now as well. All right, so we're just driving north on 53rd Street. The Oregon State University Horse Equine Facility was on the left. And as 53rd Street gets towards the top of the map, it's about to turn sharply to the right, at which point they'll change the name to Northwest Walnut Boulevard. But right around here, we're getting back into a residential area. We've got Martin Luther King Jr. Park on the left, and we've got neighborhoods near Witham Hill off to the right. And this right here is the northwest corner of town on the map. We are now on Walnut Boulevard. As we go through this construction, this is Hoover Elementary School on the right being rebuilt. And so up the hill, right behind Hoover, is the Witham Hill neighborhood. And on the left is the Timber Hill neighborhood, both of which we drive through in the narrated driving tour of Corvallis neighborhoods. If you're following along on the map, that was Northwest 29th Street that we just passed. Those are the Timber Ridge Meadows apartments on the left. And that is the Timber Hill Shopping Center off to the right. A little strip mall with grocery stores, hobby shops, pet supplies, and coffee shops. Great barbecue place there too. Alrighty, we're going to point north on Highlands now, and we are going to go away from Walnut Boulevard. If we kept going straight, we would hit 9th Street and then 99, but we are jaunting up north on Highland. We're going to go up the hill and then down the hill, in the process of which we will pass by Crescent Valley High School, one of two public high schools in the city of Corvallis, and then we'll go up into the Lewisburg Mountain View area. Check out that deer on the left. There was a deer, like a, I don't know, 6-point buck that just jaunted on by to the left. I don't know if we caught that on the forward-facing camera or not. Up here in Highlandsdale, there are some gorgeous properties on about 5 acres. We don't see those hit the market too often. That's a small little nook, but beautiful spot. We've got some lovely homes in this area too that are obviously just a moment from the north part of town. And right by Chip Ross Park, so there's a little brown sign up on the left, and Chip Ross Park is off to the left with some great trails. If I recall correctly, that connects over to the Timber Hill wildlife area, which I think we saw on the top of 29th Street. I might be crossing some wires there, but I think that's the same thing. That is Crescent Valley High School up ahead and on the left. We've got a bunch of clients and neighborhoods that are right around here, right by the high school. Some off to the right on James Place, which is just this great little tucked away neighborhood that I didn't even realize was there until I helped these guys buy the house there. They've got a third of an acre with some beautiful gardening and a great community, great neighborhood there with a big field that the kids play soccer on. Also got some clients off to the left behind the high school here on Brownlee Heights Drive on, I think, a couple of acres. Just helped them move pretty recently. So you can really get all kinds of different little neighborhoods in this spot. Crescent Valley High School off to the left. This is the older of the two high schools, if I recall correctly. This is the one that is north of town, obviously, and kind of broken up so that it feels like different buildings, like a little mini college campus for different subjects. Great education. When I used to be a public school teacher, all of my students fed into this school, and just top-notch teachers, great facility. Up ahead and on the left in the, let's say, 10 or 11 o'clock position right now on the forward-facing camera, I think that is Vineyard Mountain that we are staring at. And there's a bunch of hills, neighborhoods in the hills on Vineyard Mountain, on Concord, in the Sulphur Springs Road area further off to the left. Just lots of great hilly neighborhoods that are going to feel very similar to Grandview, where we were in the West Hills. What we're going to do is I'm going to take you on a quick jaunt on a similar neighborhood in the Mountain View area. So this is going to be Lewisburg Drive that we're about to hit the intersection with. And if you look on the map, just north of Corvallis, there's a little spot that says Lewisburg, as if it's its own town. It's part of Corvallis, as far as I'm concerned, as far as I'm aware. There is a little like Chevron City Limits Country Store up in Lewisburg, right on Highway 99, where we've got that sign. Great people own that, and it is full of microbrewed beer. You gotta check them out. And what we're gonna do is, before we get that far, we're gonna go up through the Mountain View area into McDonald's Circle. And then we're gonna take that all the way over to 99 and come back down into downtown on Highway 99. All right, we're going up Mountain View Drive now. And this will take us all the way over to 99, and we'll do a quick jaunt in the middle of it onto McDonald Circle on the Overlook area. All right, so right around here, Mountain View Drive takes a bend to the right, and if we actually keep going, this is gonna take us in just a moment all the way over to Highway 99 West, but what we're gonna do is we're gonna go and take this left right here onto Overlook Drive. I've got a number of clients up here off of Overlook Drive, so some of the street names we're driving by are going to be like McDonald's Circle, Northwest Kainui Drive. And there's a lot of parcels with a couple of acres up here. And one of the things that people really like is the proximity to the MacDun Forest. In fact, I've seen a lot of people move in this area just because they want to be able to be walking distance to trailheads and be able to go for walks or runs in the woods right out of their doorstep. we're going to take left onto McDonald Circle. Okay, so here's a quick jaunt on McDonald Circle. So this is in the Mountain View area, kind of north of Lewisburg. I just call this the Northwest Hills. And here we've got a number of lovely homes. There's a lot of, I think, 70s homes here. I've got some clients that are right here that we're passing by. Let's see, off the top of my head, 2-acre parcels for a lot of these, with homes in the 3,000 to 4,000 square foot range. And one of the things that my clients love about living in these neighborhoods right up here is that you're backing up to the MacDon Forest. So you've got walking trails right out of your backyard sometimes, and you can go into the forest on those trails for a hike or a jog. And the Arboretum is also very close by. Come to think of it, I have moved families within this neighborhood just into bigger homes over time. Alright, back on Overlook, we're going to go back the way we came for a moment, reconnect with Mountain View Drive, and then just head over to 99, and then back into downtown. From downtown, we will punch east, right out of downtown. We'll go on Van Buren, over the bridge, and we'll go towards I-5 on Highway 34, but just for a couple of minutes, and then we will check out a neighborhood by Colorado Lake Drive. That is in East Corvallis, where we've got a number of ranch homes on half-acre lots and also some larger freestanding single-family homes on 2 to 5 acre lots. So that'll be the Colorado Lake Drive area and the Pheasant Run area, kind of the Westland neighborhood, since Westland is one of the streets. All right, I think it's time for us to time warp that way. So we're back to Mountain View Drive, heading east on Mountain View Drive again, and heading towards Highway 99 West. Now we're at 99 West, and we're going south on Highway 99. She asked me what I was waiting for, I said. There's that Chevron City Limits Country Store right by the Lewisburg sign. That's the one I mentioned that's full of microbrewed beer. You gotta check that place out. And in fast motion, we're passing G3 Sports Park and some other facilities up there. Up at the 1 o'clock position, top of that hill, you could see for a split second Samaritan Regional Medical Center, the hospital. Right around here, we're back in the main part of Corvallis. This is Conifer Boulevard we just crossed over. And now this is Northwest Walnut Boulevard. I'm sorry, this is Northwest Circle Boulevard right there. And this is the part of 99 that's the shortcut from North Corvallis right into downtown. In the Corvallis Loop video, we took 9th Street instead of this shortcut. Now we're back in downtown. Maybe we can get U-Haul to sponsor this. And we just turned east on Van Buren. So we are right in the middle of downtown, in between 3rd and 4th Street. Crossing over 2nd, crossing over the bridge. That's the Willamette River. And now we're heading east on 34. So I-5 is about 15 minutes further, but we are going to go into a neighborhood. All right, Colorado Lake Drive. So we're just a few minutes east of downtown Corvallis on Highway 34. And you'll notice that we passed over a paved bike path, walking path. So you can actually bike into Corvallis while actually avoiding being on the highway. All right, Westland Drive. This will be an example spot where we've got some half acre lots with, I think, 70s ranch homes. A lot of these have shops in the backyards, which is really cool. So if you're looking for a house that's basically in Corvallis, where you still have Corvallis schools, but just a little bit further removed where you can get some space, this is a good option. Especially if you're looking for a shop. All right, another neat fun fact about this neighborhood. Let's see if I get this right. You are in the city of Corvallis, but you are in Linn County, not Benton County here. We crossed over the river. We're on the east side of the Willamette River. So I think you've got the best of both worlds in terms of having lower taxes being in Linn County, but still having like Corvallis public schools, if that's a really important thing for you. I have fond memories of this house right here. I just wanted to show you how close we are to farm fields. Pheasant Avenue, pretty much analogous to Westland Drive where we just were. There is some floodplain near this neighborhood. There's a little bit of floodplain that actually creeps into this neighborhood. I forget exactly where. So that's something that we check for. As the name implies, Colorado Lake Drive, we are near water. But most of these homes, if I recall correctly, do not have to pay flood insurance. When we talk about flood insurance in the Mid-Valley here in Oregon, we are not too concerned with, you know, your house floating away in a flood. We're more concerned with the fact that if you're in the 100-year floodplain and you can't get an elevation certificate and amend the map, that you're going to end up paying this flood insurance fee if you have a loan on the property. And that's not really a fee that you can, you know, shop around for or negotiate. And so it's really annoying. There is a manufactured home park up ahead of us. In the interest of time, I'm just going to take a quick jaunt onto one of these roads and then just turn right back around. But here's an example where I've got some clients and friends that live off this particular road, a lovely house on about 5 acres, and it's just a really quiet spot. So right up against grass farm fields here. There are other neighborhoods that are south of Highway 34 in this same general area. if I recall correctly, Terra Circle, East Terra. There's a little sign out front. I think we passed by it already. And there's a bunch of, you know, homes that are on a couple of acres out there too. I elected to take you into this neighborhood because it's easy to turn left into it because there is a turn lane. Then it's easy, of course, to go back into downtown because you could just turn right on Highway 34. All right, we are back on Highway 34 and we are just heading back towards downtown Corvallis. Farm stand on the left. You can see Mary's Peak off in the distance, straight ahead. Looks really small on the wide-angled lens, but it's a great view normally. You've got a golf course off to the right. I believe that is Trysting Tree Golf Course, as well as an OSU rowing facility. Crossing back over the Willamette River. All right, folks, I'm going to stop the video here. If we have a chance after my next appointment, we'll recharge those batteries and take a jaunt down to Bellfountain, for example. So right about here, we are getting back into downtown. This is Harrison, which is the two-lane bridge coming into downtown. And what we're going to do is we are going to head towards Bellfountain Road and pick up the video there for the final part of the expansion pack. All right, so just going through downtown, now going south on 4th Street. Remember, this is Highway 99, basically unzipped like a zipper. Protests outside the courthouse. Lots of little shops and restaurants. Great downtown. And ahead of us, it looks like there's kind of an overpass, underpass situation. If you keep going straight, you end up just in Southtown Corvallis right there. But we're gonna go off to the right on to basically reconnect with Highway 34, also known as Willamette Boulevard in this spot. So we're just heading west through Southwest Corvallis. You can see Reaser Stadium and Oregon State University track fields off to the right there. And this is basically giving us a shortcut from downtown to the southwest corner of town where Willamette Boulevard meets Southwest 53rd Street. In normal driving time, it would be about 5 minutes to go from downtown to that southwest corner of town. And we've just got this sped up a little bit, of course. You've got Safeway and Bi-Mart, grocery stores and restaurants and shops off to the left there in the Sunset Shopping Center. And here is that southwest corner of town. We're at Southwest 53rd Street. If we keep going straight, we end up in Willamette about 5 minutes later. But we are now going south on 53rd Street. Okay, we are now pointed south on 53rd Street, and this is the southwest corner of the map as it appears. So if you pay close attention, you'll notice a costume change in a second here, and we're going to continue punching south and go to Bellfountain Road and beyond. Hey folks, it's Michael again. This is going to be the last of the extensions on the expansion pack, showing some rural property options that are technically in Corvallis but feel very far removed for those of you that would like to get some space around you. So we are heading south on 53rd Street. So we're just kind of leaving the main part of Southwest Corvallis, and we are going to go by Bellfountain and beyond.
All right, south on 53rd. Now we're pointed west. I think this is Chapel Drive, maybe. We're just basically going in between Corvallis and Willamette right now. But as we get into the southeast corner of Willamette, we're gonna go south on Bellfountain.
The houses in the hills that you're seeing off to the right are the east end of Philomath, and this is the Nebeek Hill Benton View area.
And we're going to be going south on that road, so straight ahead south on Bellfountain. Now we're south on Bellfountain. So we're going to keep this in time warp mode because we're going to be going south on Bellfountain in real time for about 15 minutes or so. Right now I'm on my way to a rural property that's located just vaguely off of Bellfountain Road to do some well sample testing. And we are passing by farm fields, so there's grass fields obviously as you can see, but there's also some other really cool stuff. There's Christmas tree farms, hazelnut tree farms, or as they are called in Oregon, filbert tree farms. Apparently that's the same thing as hazelnuts, but I'm from the East Coast originally, so I think of them as hazelnuts. And there's a lot of property on acreage here. I've got some clients that are on 5 acres right over here, 5 acres a stone's throw from here that are actually in Philomath because we're near the border there. And there's just a lot of opportunities to get, I would say, like 5 to 15 acres of residential property. And it's a beautiful drive. You'll often see cyclists, which I'm sure we'll pass some on this trip as well. Cycling's a great hobby if you're in the Mid-Valley. You have really easy access to flatlands in the valley or hills to do your climbing, because we're nestled into the coast range. And we actually just passed a charter school. I think it's called Muddy Creek Charter School. So this is still Corvallis. And now we're just getting near property that I've got under contract with some buyers of mine. Really excited for these guys. I hope they watch this video and get to see it. And it's a residential house on, off the top of my head, I think 14 acres or so. And we're going to go find the well head for the well flow and potability test. Something that we do when we have rural properties on wells, as the name of the test would imply. So just another great example of, you know, a place where you can be, let's say, 15 or 20 minutes away from Corvallis, or rather from downtown Corvallis. This is maybe a little bit further, probably 20-something minutes by the time we actually get to this particular house. And so you've got the great feel of, you know, having a retreat in the woods, but you're still in Corvallis, you still have Corvallis schools, and, you know, you're still a part of that community. All right, we found that well. So folks, thanks so much for checking out the expansion pack to the narrated driving tour of Corvallis neighborhoods. In this expansion pack, we're wrapping up here off of Bellfountain Road, lovely property on some acreage, as you can see. And we just hope that this has been a great resource for you too. So this is a follow-up to that narrated driving tour. If you haven't seen that and you stumbled upon this one first, feel free to check out that narrated driving tour of Corvallis neighborhoods. This is the expansion showing some rural areas. And our next video, we'll put a link to on the screen too, will be a quick tour of the Corvallis loop, just the driving loop around town, because it's kind of a circle. All right, thanks for checking us out, and bye for now.